This is the best day to finish up our season for this year. It's just the best day. It's worked hard all year to make this happen, and tonight we have our Christmas party, and this is what we're going to celebrate.
The two hydraulic rams there that push it together, and it just, so the hitch goes up and down. They can raise it up.
Original Bank of Commerce building in Pincher Creek, constructed in 1906. It was one of approximately 50 prefabricated Bank of Commerce buildings destined for small towns on the Canadian prairies at that time. They were manufactured and built, or started to put together in the Vancouver area, and then railroaded out to the small towns across the Canadian prairies. Ours arrived here in the summer of 1906 at Pincher Station, which is then known as Pincher City, and then was drayed in the Pincher Creek to its original location in downtown Pincher Creek, which is at the corner of Main Street and East Avenue. It was one of the prominent business blocks in the community at that point, or an old ranching settlement. It served as the Bank of Commerce business in Pincher Creek until the 31st of December 1934, at which point it became the municipal offices for the municipal district of Robert Kerr, which is the old municipality down in the Twin Butte area. It was purchased from the bank for a sum of $2,000, and they used it until 1944 when the municipality became the municipal district of Pincher Creek. And so the new municipality used the offices for another 20 years until 1964. During the 1940s and the 1950s, the bank building and the MD building also doubled as a local law office. And it was originally Carswell and Jackson who were the law partners. In 1956, the firm was joined by Garth Turcott, who had a law practice in this building for 33 years in 1989. In 1964, when the MD moved to its new offices on Kettle Street, the building was purchased by Garth Turcott and Company, and he continued there for another 25 years. At that point, Mr. Turcott retired from active legal business. The building was sold, and at that point moved to its new location on Hewitson Avenue. So this move in 2014 is actually a second move and celebrates the 25th anniversary of the first move that's happened a quarter century later. So we're very pleased to have the building here because it represents a tangible link to Pincher Creek's commercial history, and it's probably one of the only buildings that we'll get from our business history, because the other business buildings have a permanent face on Pincher Creek's Main Street. One of the ones that have an historical value, like the King Edward Hotel, the Alberta Hotel, and the other ones have all been torn down or unfortunately burnt down and things like that. So we're very pleased to have this reminder of our commercial history here in Pincher Creek's vibrant history.
A lot of the costs that were given to us were discounted in an incredible way because so many people were really on top of this project. And I know that we got a good deal from the mover. It was about a third of his regular cost. Kerners moved this building in 1989, 25 years ago, from its location there on Main Street over to where it was over by Hewitson by the bridge. So he was really enthusiastic to come back and do this again. And we were really enthusiastic too because he was so excited to do
it. So this is the same mover?
Same guys. Kelly, that's the head guy here, was there 25 years ago. Just 25 years younger.
So he knows the building.
He knows the building, and he was pretty excited to come here. He felt like he told everybody what to do, and it was like he'd done it already. You know, he was the grunt, though, 25 years ago, and this time he's the boss. You know, a lot of people are asking me, what are we going to do with this building? And the very honest answer is, when you get something donated, especially like this building, we didn't go out looking for it. So we didn't have a need for this building, but yet the need when you have a historic building like this is you need to get it before it's destroyed. And we needed to have this building as the last piece of commercial history off of Main Street, Pincher Creek, that didn't burn down in the fires over the last 100 years. And it was just amazing that we could get it and that it was donated to us. And so, you know, the small job, it feels like today, of getting it here with all the permitting process and the fundraising and the millions of hours, 800 hours of volunteer labor went into getting this building here. And that's mostly from our workday crew that were here on Wednesdays. But a lot of them were here Mondays, Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays, and sometimes Saturdays. We had a lot to do, and that's the only way we could afford to do it. Yeah, that was the Union Bank was originally our Royal Bank, or the Royal Bank took over the Union Bank, and that's what we had in this spot before this building. But that the Union Bank looks incredible over there where it is, framing the entryway into Pioneer Route site. And this bank is incredible right here because it goes with the architecture of the other buildings around it because of its height. There's a lot of people that have been saying to me, oh, it's so big, it's so high, it's not going to fit. Do you know what? When this building is in place right here, it's going to look like it's been there like it belongs. Our next step with this building is just to hook the power up. We have 100 amp service to this little spot right here for when the other Union Bank was here. And this building runs on 100 amp service. So the first thing we're going to do is put power back into it because it's all here and at no cost. I have a volunteer that can help out with that power. And that's going to be the first thing we do. We're going to spend the winter figuring out some exhibits that are going to go into it and what we actually would like to do with this building.